Hey everybody, today we're kicking off a new series where we explore macOS apps that you only need to pay for once. If you're tired of those monthly app payments, you're in the right place. Juggling multiple windows and losing track of your workflow? This Windows Switcher app might be the solution you need. Let's dive in with our first app, Contexts. You've always been able to switch windows with Command Tab on a Mac. However, Contexts is a macOS app designed to make window management more streamlined and enhances the functionality. No more hunting through a cluttered dock or using cumbersome shortcuts. With Contexts, you can quickly find and switch to the window you need. Let's go ahead and install Contexts. To do so, go to contexts.co and click on Download Free Trial. Again, one of the things I love about this app is you can buy it for $9.99 and it's yours forever. Once installed, Contexts will automatically start running. You can access it by pressing a customizable keyboard shortcut. The default is Command Tab. So right now I'm holding down Command and I'm pressing Tab, and if you hold down Shift and press Tab with Command, it goes back up. So no more fumbling through your dock or mission control. It's nice because you can actually read what windows are open, or you can press one of the letters on the left to go ahead and quickly jump to what you want. So I'll do SA, and that goes back to Safari. One of the features that I really love about this app is its ability to be customized. So let's go ahead and go into Context. Alt-Tab, I have it open here, and there's a whole bunch of settings that are really great. So one of the first things that you want to do is make sure that Launch Contexts at Login is checked next to where it says auto launch. In the general area, it's just customizing your keyboard layout, a few areas here. Not going to go through each of these settings because there are a lot of them and they are great. Now the sidebar I haven't shown yet. I mean, we'll get to that in just a minute. Now with panel, it's the settings that show up in the middle when you trigger the app. There's some shortcuts here that are handy to remember for the panel. So you can quit an app by pressing Command Q. So basically you're holding down Command anyway, and then you're pressing Tab. And if you want to quit an app, so let's say I wanted to quit Telegram here, I'll hover over it and choose Q on my keyboard, and that will quit that app. While pressing Command Tab, you can quickly get to search by typing S on the keyboard while holding Command. One thing to remember is that you have to hold the Command key down as you type, and you can use your arrow keys to move up and down the menu too. In the search feature, Control Space is the default shortcut. So if we go ahead and press Control Space, we can be able to type in any search command that we want. You can even modify it if you don't want to use Command Tab. My favorite feature so far has to be gestures. If we click on gestures, you can check the box next to scroll down from the top edge with two fingers. On the Magic Trackpad or MacBook Trackpad, I can swipe from the top right or left and the panel appears. There might be times where I'm doing something mouse intensive, say design work or video editing, and I don't want to switch back and forth. I can pull this up quickly, which is really nice. All right, let's look at the panel on the side. If I put my mouse over it here, it expands, and this can be set to show icons or show icons and title start. So with that, it gives just a preview of some of the text there. On the dock, I've turned hiding on and have been using this as a dock replacement. I like that I can see multiple windows in an app at a glance. For instance, Safari here. Overall, Contexts has a clean and intuitive interface. It doesn't even feel like a third-party tool. It just feels like a natural extension of your Mac. Be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos diving into tips on tech, productivity, retro gaming, and everything else in between. For a look at another Mac app, see our video on NotePlan 3, and I'll see you on the next one.